Hello everyone, my name is Araya Long and I am a graduate assistant at UIC's Library of Health Sciences. In this video, we will be looking at Zotero, the free, easy-to-use citation manager that helps you collect, organize, annotate, cite, and share research. I will demonstrate various methods you can use with Zotero to save your references individually and in batches. We will also go over how to create bibliographies. To start, I want to say a quick note about the browser extension for Zotero. The Zotero browser extension allows you to seamlessly save sources to your Zotero account while browsing through sources online. This is a main method for saving references to Zotero. To use this feature, you would have to download the Zotero browser extension and pin it to the extension bar in your browser. Using the browser extension of Zotero is as simple as clicking the Zotero symbol. Once you have found a source online you want to add to your collection. From there, the source is automatically added to the folder you have selected in Zotero. To learn more about Zotero's browser extension, you can visit our Introduction to Zotero video linked in the description below that covers setting up your Zotero account. I will now show you a couple other ways you can input sources into Zotero outside of the browser extension method. I will start with the Identifier tool. The Identifier tool looks like a magic wand and is located in the top bar of both the online and desktop versions in Zotero. You simply input the URL, DOI, or the PubMed ID of your resource and Zotero works to find the remaining information. If the browser extension or Identifier tool doesn't gather all of the information you need on your source, you may enter in the parent item information manually. To do this, select the plus icon on the desktop or online version, then select the source type, book, journal article, etc., and if you hover over the More button, you will see there are more options for source types. From there, you can enter all of the information you have. If you are starting with a PDF, you can right-click and select Create Parent Item to create a record associated with this paper, and from there, you enter in an identifier. You can also drag and drop sources into Zotero. If you have a source downloaded to your desktop already, you can drag and drop it into a folder and the system will retrieve its metadata. Sometimes Zotero is unable to find the metadata. If Zotero doesn't retrieve this metadata, you can input it manually by selecting the plus symbol as mentioned before and entering in the source information. Now that we've gone over inputting a singular source, I will now demonstrate how you can input multiple sources at one time into Zotero. Let's say you are researching and you get to a page of results that looks promising for your research, systematic review, or other project. You are able to import a batch of articles to Zotero, and I will demonstrate how to do so in PubMed. I will also show you where you can find additional resources on saving multiple sources to Zotero. So here I have a page of results from PubMed. The first step is to press the Send To button in PubMed, then select Citation Manager. Next, you will choose if you want to export all the results on just the page, or a selection of sources. You can choose a selection by checking the boxes of the sources you want to export. Once you decide on this, you will create your file. To get this downloaded file into Zotero, go to File in the top menu and select Import. Then select a file and make sure that the box that says Place Imported Collections and Items into Collection is unchecked. Then you will navigate to your downloaded file from PubMed. Make sure you have the library selected that you would like the sources to be uploaded to while doing this import process. Then you will see here that all of the sources on that page downloaded into the selected folder in Zotero. For demonstrations on how to do this same process in other databases, please visit the following site: researchguides.uac.edu/systematic-reviews/citation-management. It will be linked in the description of this video. And no matter which database you use, you can look for the option to export, share, or send to Citation Manager to save multiple sources to Zotero. Now I will show you how to create a citation list for when you are finished with your research or gathering sources. In Zotero, select all of the sources you want to be in your bibliography. I did so by holding down Shift and selecting multiple sources. From here, right-click on the sources and select the Create Bibliography from Items option, then select your citation style. To finalize the export into a Microsoft Word document, you can select the Bibliography option for your output mode, and for your output method, select Save as RTF, or Rich Text Format, and you can choose where you want the file to be saved on your computer. Here, you can see the Word document you created by navigating to the file on your computer. You also have the option to copy to clipboard or print your bibliography. That concludes our video on saving references to Zotero. If you need help setting up your Zotero account or want to learn more about Zotero's features, make sure to check out our first video about Zotero titled Introduction to Zotero, linked in the description below. For help with saving references and citation managers, feel free to make an appointment with your subject librarian through any of the contact methods on the UIC Library homepage. The Library of Health Sciences thanks you for watching.